We are here with Pepe Agell. He is the founder of VP of Business in Chartboost.
Yes. Hi, Carolina. How are you? Good morning.
Good morning. Well, thank you for, because today is raining, it's a bad day, but I mean, it's the weather is always...
There's never a bad day.
Yeah, exactly. It's like the weather always is... It's raining, it's not bad days. Yeah, exactly. So tell about what is your company about? This is Chartboost. It's about games. It's about something like play. You play a lot here in your office.
We do play a lot of games. We don't make games, but we work with a lot of game developers. So Chartboost is a platform that helps game developers with two things that are very, very essential. The first one, once you have games, your own game, you need to get users. So we help you acquire users. And the second one is once you have traffic in your game, you need to make money. Hopefully you're building a business with your game. So we help game developers make money by promoting other people's games. So it's essentially a platform where you can come in and you can make money with Chartboost by showing ads, or you can spend money and acquire users, valuable users, because they're players through the Chartboost platform. And this is us. We started 5 years ago, and here we are in the heart of Soma, in our headquarters.
Huge office. Yeah. How many people work for you?
So we have around 140 people. San Francisco is our biggest office. It's where we have the headquarters, and then we have Amsterdam, which is our headquarters for Europe, where we have around 18 people, and then we have a small, very small office in Tokyo. So we have three offices, 140 people distributed across three offices.
How is the secret how you grow up super fast from in 5 years? It's like, it's unbelievable, because here there are a lot of competition.
There's a lot of competition, and also when you think about mobile advertising, which at the end it's the industry in which we're competing with huge companies like Facebook and Google, right? And we're obviously not Facebook and Google. Mm-hmm. They have greater teams, greater budgets, and so it's tough. But you know, we were born because Chartboost was actually born because Sean and Maria, our co-founders, they experienced a pain making games, and it was their own pain. And this is why we're not just here to make mobile advertising, we're here to help game developers. And that pain, the pain of having to deal with ad networks that are not necessarily the most transparent, that don't give you the control, it's really what made our initial product very different from the rest. And this is, we're always looking for that differentiation, which is, what is it that we can do to help game developers that others, including Facebook and Google, cannot do, right? So it's really this focus on helping games that has given us an advantage, at least in this vertical, right? Mm-hmm. So, and it's always important when you're a small guy, when you're a small company, it's always important to find that unique angle that you have, that it's really different from whatever everyone else is doing.
Mm-hmm. And is your first company?
It is not my first startup. I've been in Silicon Valley for 8 years. Actually, now I'm turning eight here in the Bay Area, and I've been in two startups before. And so did Maria, my wife, also. She worked at two different startups before till we decided to join forces here in mm-hmm. Chartboost.
What's your advice for another entrepreneurs that they are looking for, like thinking to do with another company?
Here in Silicon Valley specifically, or in general?
I think you
really need to go for something that excites you. Mm-hmm. I know that sometimes being an entrepreneur has been idealized, and it's cool, and oh, you're an entrepreneur. It's usually cool in certain circles, but the reality is that being an entrepreneur is not easy. It's mm-hmm. not easy. It's probably the unsexiest job I can think of. It means hard work. It means short nights. It means a lot of energy put into one project. So the least thing you can do is at least be super excited for that project, right? So the first thing is you need to be passionate about whatever you're building. Mm-hmm. If it's not something that resonates with your life, that resonates with your pains, that resonates with your objectives, don't do it. It's not only about a market opportunity, it's really about what really passions you. Mm-hmm. So that would be my first advice. And the second one is really about hiring people, not only that are smarter than you, but also that you can have fun with. Because again, you're gonna spend long days with these people, and the least thing you can do is have fun and enjoy the time that you have with your coworkers and your team members.
It's true. So, it's very important, the team.
Yeah. Absolutely. The team is key. And honestly, in good moments, I mean, there are other reasons to celebrate, but in bad moments, it's really the team that pushes you forward, right? So it's being surrounded by people that you admire, that you really enjoy working with, that makes you feel that whatever the challenge is, you're gonna overcome it, right? So.
Nice. What are your goals, personal and professional?
Oh, personal. So personally, I became a father 2 years ago for the first time. Now I have a second child as well. So personally, I love living in San Francisco with my family. Obviously, we miss home. Barcelona will always be home, and we do go there quite often. And so anyways, personally, I love living in San Francisco, being able to go to Spain from time to time. And I don't know, I want to be a good father, and I want to have kids that speak very well Spanish, English, hopefully Catalan, and other languages, right?
Exactly,
so that would be my personal
Chinese,
goal.
Yeah.
Exactly. That would be my personal goal. Professionally, obviously, I want this company to become bigger in whatever form that means. I'm not thinking about a specific exit strategy, we have a clear vision. The industry is huge, the community of developers is huge. In fact, we're expanding to non-games as well, which is even bigger, right? We're helping app developers that want to acquire audiences that are super valuable within games. We're helping them, or even brands. There's a big opportunity for us to connect games with brands, right? So I know that the market opportunity is there, is huge, so I'd like to see Chartboost really becoming the de facto monetization tool for games and for anyone who has content that wants to be promoted in these audiences. They find the channel to get those users.
Cool. Yeah. So, wow, amazing! When I hear you, you look like very passionate about your job and your good energy.
You have to bring that energy, right? And I also get the energy from the team and from everything we do. Also from the challenges and the difficulties, right?
And what is the thing that you can do, you cannot do?
The thing that I cannot do is...
For example, you want to advise someone, hey, if you want to start a company, don't do that.
Oof, we've made so many mistakes.
Yeah, that's a mistake, no?
Let me
something
see.
Like a is top of your head.
I've made mistakes thinking that, I mean, startups change a lot, and they're in continuous change. And I've made the mistake of considering certain teams families. Startups are not families. It's great to have this environment where you're challenged, where you admire people, but they're not families. Families, you need to take care of your parents, your cousins, you should not break these relationships. But in startups, there are moments in which there's people that it's better to actually let go and for them to go to some other project, and nothing happens, right? I've been in the past very attached to certain people just because they've been at Chartboost for a long time without realizing that the company has changed so much that it's maybe better for them to go to another project, right? First, because there's people that thrive at early stages and not when the company is bigger, right? Right now we have already over 100 people, and dynamics are very different than when we were 10, right? So you cannot pretend that everyone that was here when we were 10 will go through all the stages of the company, right? And the other way around, and there's people that when you see that they're not performing very well, you need to also make some of these decisions faster, right? I always say that you need to hire slowly and fire fast.
Wow.
That's and I've made definitely mistakes on sometimes not firing fast.
Yeah, this is the key here. And maybe we're more like, we have more empathy.
Yeah.
And Americans are more direct. And more.
Yes, and nothing happens, especially in this market. I mean, people find jobs and the same way, I mean, many people give you notice and tomorrow I'm not coming, and then you need to realize what to do, right? So I think it's not bad. It's not a bad thing. And I keep great relationships with some of the old team members, but I'm very happy to see them also grow in other companies, right? And I think as leaders and as entrepreneurs, you need to realize that your company will change and so will your teams, right? And there's no such a thing as family that will survive throughout the years and the different stages. No, you need to bring, at some point, you need to bring executives that have managed bigger teams and that have that experience that maybe you're lacking, right? So the team will change, right? And don't get too attached to it, because there are stages for everyone.
Exactly.
There are stages for everyone.
Wow. Thank you for your words. I really enjoy and learn a lot with you.
Thank you, Carolina. Okay. It's always good. Okay. After 4 years since the first interview.
Yeah,
so.
Exactly. And it's total change. Yeah.
Exactly.
Okay,
perfect.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
You.